You've spent countless hours perfecting your product, and now you're ready to ship. But what if something goes wrong during ground transportation over high mountain passes, or even during a flight to a customer? You're risking significant amounts of time and money, even if just a single product is damaged, let alone if an entire shipping container gets rejected by a distributor or client. At any given moment during transportation, either using ground or air vehicles, products have the potential to suffer both damage and leaks due to changing atmospheric pressure while in transit. For instance, packages transported over mountain passes can reach altitudes as high as 3,600 meters. Commercial airline cabins are typically pressurized to simulate an altitude of 2,400 meters. And feeder aircrafts, often used for transporting aid or military packages, can travel at altitudes up to 4,900 meters and are not pressurized. Then, if your product is being shipped to different cities like San Francisco at 16 meters, Mexico City at 2,240 meters, and La Paz, Bolivia at 3,600 meters above sea level, it is crucial to know that your packaging is made to withstand the changes in atmospheric pressure along the way. Test method. The best way to assess the risk of leaks, damage, or deformation is to run a transportation test using a vacuum chamber and following the ASTM D6653 methodology, with parameters dependent on the specific altitude and transportation conditions. In this example, the products are traveling from high to low atmospheric pressure. The production plant is located at sea level, and we know that most commercial flights have a cabin pressure that reflects the average atmospheric pressure found around 2,400 meters. To calculate the pressure difference, subtract altitude 1, the altitude in meters of the production plant, minus altitude 2, equivalent to the altitude that the cabin is going to be pressurized to, and divide the result by 10. In this case, 0 meters minus 2,400 meters divided by 10 equals minus 240 millibars. For quick, pragmatic calculations, remember that a change of 1,000 meters roughly equals minus 100 millibars. However, if you want to be more accurate, we suggest following the two tables of temperature and pressure correlation found on the ASTM D6653. Fortunately, there's an easy way not to deal with these calculations if you are the owner of one of our CDVs. By using the transportation test and indicating the production and shipping or delivery altitudes, ORION OS will calculate the necessary pressure for each test. With the advantage of storing up to 99 transportation profiles to easily perform tests on different products or travel conditions, it is now the time to run a test. So, the first step is to increase the vacuum gradually to an equivalent rate of 305 meters every 30 to 60 seconds. Our app allows you to set those two parameters, elevation step and step time. Once the target maximum vacuum has been reached, maintain the vacuum level for 60 minutes. This testing time can be modified according to your experience and knowledge of the transportation conditions. Then, the pressure has to go back to the initial level at the previous rate of 305 meters for every 30 to 60 seconds. Once the test is over, you can open the lid and continue to the interpretation stage. The system will ask if the test has failed or passed, and you can save the results directly into the SD card or print a ticket. Interpretation. So, how can we determine if a package has failed the test? Well, this will depend on the packaging and content type. If the package contains liquids, leaks will be readily apparent. On the other hand, if the container doesn't have any liquids, you may observe irreversible deformations. However, there might not be any leaks, even though the physical changes are severe. There's also the possibility that the contrary would happen, where a leak is present in a seemingly perfect container. In any of these cases, we recommend performing a leak test. Our instructional videos will guide you through the process for both rigid and flexible packaging. And remember, our CDV vacuum chambers are designed to perform all of these test methods in an intuitive way. Get in contact with us using the links in the description if you're interested in getting one. DVACI. package leak testing instruments.